So welcome to the press conference. We have the fourth game finished, and Vladimir Kramnik and Sergei Karjakin made a draw today in today's game. Vladimir, actually, at the opening press conference, you said that you are expecting Berlin defense here in this event, especially that we are here in Berlin. But could you imagine it will come so early in the second round, and especially against Sergei?
I could imagine, but I could more imagine it that it would come from the black side, from me. And I can tell you, I usually play it with black, and it's such a pleasure to look at this position from the white side. It doesn't happen very often, yeah.
Yeah, so it was not a bad surprise for you, it was...
No, it was not a bad surprise, it was a good surprise.
Yeah. Sergei, you decided to play Berlin defense because you're in Berlin, or partly?
Maybe partly, but it's my main opening, I watched it a lot, but in today's game I probably mixed up some lines because there are so many lines with the different moves like rook e1, g3, and then after bishop b4, white has some moves like g4, a3, and some other moves, and I mix it up, I think, and I'm not sure about my 97, but it's a question of the opponent knowledge. And probably I had some very deep notes, but I didn't remember them. And then I got a very tricky position, and I think it was very important moment after knight f1. I played knight f5, which is probably fine because immediately knight d5. F4 was dangerous, but after knight f5, g3, it was maybe the most difficult.
Yeah, I'm not sure that g3 is a good move now. I'm not so sure because actually I thought it was just so smooth, g3, f3, king g2, but I didn't, of course, simply didn't understand that black can go back all of a sudden, like losing two tempis, but in fact, it's not so, yeah? I mean, okay, g3 is a logical move, but maybe I should have done something like rook e4. I think white is better here. I mean, it's clear black is suffering. You probably can make a draw, but it's far from a draw still. And g3 looked positionally very good, but yeah, then when I played it, I saw that knight e7, and now, okay, I mean, it's black is holding by tempis, yeah, because, okay, if white just manages f3, g4, but of course here I spend a lot of time trying to make work knight e3. But
bishop
h3, and it seems that black is holding. I mean, takes check, looks terribly dangerous for black. King f8 only move, knight c7, rook c8 only move, e6. But I mean the only move is take with a pawn, knight e6. I think you have to take, and now it seems that maybe even rook e8 or king f7, rook e5. Okay, white is still better, but probably it should be a draw. Rook c7, rook d5. I mean, white is still pressing, but yeah. I was trying to make work lots of strange things, even move like g4, but it's too crazy. Then finally, yes, here it's just a matter. I mean, if I manage my knight on e3 here, it's almost over, but I'm a bit not in time with knight d5. There are lots of possibilities here, but finally I went for c4, knight b6, knight e3, knight takes c4. Yeah, here knight d5, I was hesitating between knight d5 and knight takes c4. Knight d5 is an interesting move.
What
also
Sergei would do if knight d5?
I would probably play knight b2.
Yeah, I thought knight b2. Yeah,
considering, yeah, yeah, that
I was considering this line. Takes on a8.
And actually I have two moves here, like knight c3 is natural, but also I have knight b2, I thought. But
knight b2, no, I mean still knight c7, yeah.
Yeah, but knight
I thought knight c4, I was calculating this. Knight c3, I mean, knight c7 and maybe king g8 looks very dubious for black, but it's not so clear. I mean, he wants to get his king. I mean, I was keep on calculating here like this, knight d5. Takes, trying to get the line or the pawn, but somehow maybe black is escaping here. I mean, should be still white is pressing, but I was not sure. Yeah, and then I saw this concept, which I actually liked very much, because all of a sudden, besides extra pawn, I mean, I noticed that I'm just pushing my pawns, and well, with good winning chances, that's what I thought, and actually, I was expecting c6, maybe here. I mean, at some point.
Yeah, but I didn't want to.
Yeah, it's a bit, because here, actually, I thought it was close to winning this position. I mean, I thought white should manage to break through.
I think I played b6, which was a little bit inaccurate. I should have played bishop a4 immediately, because after b6, white had bishop
d8. I could have played rook bishop d8, but I didn't want the rook, that you get out with a rook. And okay, of course, white is still better. But frankly, I thought that there must be a way to break through here for white, because there are lots of interesting options. Actually, I don't know if this is, this is an option, strangely enough. Takes, king g8, king f4. I mean, I'm just threatening f6, but okay, if I have my pawn on c3 here, probably it's winning, because, but here, okay, you take and f6. I mean, it's actually very strong attack all of a sudden, but I'm not sure without this pawn that I'm mating. I mean, this I'm not sure. I wanted to get my pawn to c3 and to do the same.
Yeah, but here maybe rook d8, and then...
Yes, here, because you have check. Yeah, that's why I need my pawn on c3, and then there is no check. Yeah, then probably it's winning. So I was, rook d2, f6. I mean, bishop c2 is not even a threat, really, because I have rook d7, yeah? So here I was considering maybe I could do this, actually. This was interesting. I mean...
Maybe some king g8.
But king g8, yeah, with the idea that if rook h2, then I might win a very important tempi after rook h1, takes, and c3 and f6. But... So I decided rook c1, king g8, c4. I thought it should, basically I just need my rook to defile, but it's strangely enough, it's not so easy to manage. There are lots of black cannot do anything, but lots of different plans for white. And I was happy that I managed my rook to e3 somewhere here, this. And now, sometimes e6 I should go, at some point.
Is this moment?
Yes, because I was, this would be nice, bishop f4 maybe, and then trying to go e6.
Yeah, it was possible.
But then you immediately get the d line, rook d8, e6, and I was not sure that, for example, then bishop will blockade somehow on e8. Of course, there are many options, so I decided for the moment just to make the time control. And here, yes. Also, even here e6 is interesting. Here rook e6, I was considering.
And here I think king h7.
King h7?
Yeah.
No, I didn't like take rook h1, because I thought that this might be just kind of...
Maybe you have rook e7.
Rook e7, yeah. I mean, I rejected it because of rook takes e6 and rook e6, rook h1, and black. Mm-hmm. I seem to be very close with my rook e7, but black starts counterplay with g1.
Yeah, and then maybe even rook d1, rook d7.
I need a good moment to make it, but I couldn't really. The thing is that if rook d3, also interesting, then f6 is coming, and bishop f4. It also makes some sense, but takes bishop e5, and then trying to enter to pick up this pawn. But for the moment,
I think Sergei provoked this moment. He played this rook h6 and
rook h6 is the right move, of course, yeah, because actually it's like almost zugzwang for black. And actually I want e6 probably here already.
No, but I think I should have some moves, only...
Because I might be already threatening e6 because I closed the line, yeah.
Mm-hmm. But if I go bishop d7, then...
D7, but then it's very important that I'm getting my line.
Bishop a4?
Yeah, and then bishop d8, yeah, that's already... Bishop d8, yeah, that looks quite dangerous. Rook h6, the problem is that, I wanted to do this anyway, but then I realized there is very strange thing like this all of a sudden. I was trying to make this work, but it doesn't work. Yes, takes rook f8 and rook d6 even. Mm-hmm. So, but here g5, and takes. First I thought that this might be also good, but then I realized that it's not so clear because rook h6 is very unpleasant move, attacking the bishop, and then rook h7, rook e7. It's very, very close, but g5 also, I thought maybe this was good, but then I also found some nasty thing here. There was some nasty trick. I already forgot what was it. I think it was rook h, bishop c2 somewhere, I don't remember. Yeah, something. I mean,
Maybe just take on yeah, g5
take,
and rook.
Take, yeah, rook h5. Yeah, this actually is not so simple because rook, rook enters and then bishop c2. There are something. I mean, I was searching for a good moment and I thought, yeah, I could have started with g5, but first of all, anyway, rook h8, e6, but also there is some ridiculous move g6 here. I was not sure if I can win it. So I started with e6, and here, yeah, it's very, very close, but it doesn't seem to work. I mean, rook h8, also maybe rook h7 is working. And here, yes, unfortunately, g6, there is rook h5. It seems, it's at least to me, it seems that it worked. It works.
Yeah, it worked.
I mean, although maybe rook e6, maybe there are some kind of slow mates, but I don't believe it, yeah. But yeah, I mean, this problem is rook f8 here. Yeah, that's a problem. Actually, what I missed, frankly, I thought that I wanted here to play, I think, king g4 or something. Yeah, that was my plan. Bishop d7, I think. And now some brilliant combination, but it was not working. Yeah, I was thinking here about playing g6. Yeah, that was my big plan. But I don't know, maybe there are other reasons, but the main problem is takes, and now actually, I mean, if I get king g5, e7, it's just winning, and rook to d8, but what I mean is that here black has rook f6, I mean, this
g6 is
this
handy.
Is a very strong resource here, rook f6, and well, maybe, by the way, e7, maybe king can escape.
Yeah, maybe I should play, I mean, rook h to g6 and then rook e6 and queen and I thought rook e6 e8 takes king h7.
Yeah, that's also of course possible, but I mean, yeah, that was actually my idea, but then I saw something also, yeah, that was the plan. Then I saw also, I mean, I was not sure if rook e5 doesn't work because takes rook h4 king g5, but here takes yes, and probably it's quite force. Rook h6, king g5, and now, yeah, rook e7 seems that it's like a box, yeah. But then I saw rook f6, and here I stopped after I saw rook f6. Maybe I shouldn't have stopped, yeah, maybe I should have at least tried to. Yeah, because rook e5 is already not really what I was planning, frankly. I mean, I also had some ideas of playing king g4 here.
But it's what we discussed.
Yes. Ah, yeah. No, no. I mean, not here. Sorry, I confused. I mean, yeah, like g6, it doesn't. Yeah, I mean, there's, of course, rook e5 is already. Even g6 is possible here. Takes rook d8, some strange play.
So, Vladimir, what do you feel? I mean, e6 was the right moment, actually, to play it or not?
No, probably not, but it's very difficult. I mean, maybe it's not. Maybe black holds, objectively, just very unpleasant for black. Looks like white has good winning chances, but, yeah, it obviously probably was not the right moment, because here, bishop c2, and actually here, still, strangely enough, rook e7, yeah, rook g8. If not rook g8, there are some problems, yeah, but it's just...
Yeah, but maybe I should have played rook h7 immediately after f6.
You mean after f6?
Yeah.
Rook h7, no, I thought it was very dangerous because I start attacking your bishop now.
But I will go bishop g6.
I thought I had some idea here. Or maybe I just play rook e7. I mean, it's a draw, probably. Yeah, because here check and rook e7, rook g8. I wouldn't say only move, but close to this, yeah, because I'm threatening rook gg7 simply. And okay, just simply the pawn is very strong. And this. I'm not actually sure if black holds here because I thought I have rook g4, which is very unpleasant. And bishop to f6, cutting the king. King comes, maybe some mating nets. At least very dangerous for black, yeah. But rook g8, and then, I mean, at least I could have f7, of course, I wanted, but rook f8, yeah. And it's just like somehow.
Actually, I think I can even take on g5 and play king g7, which is also draw.
I thought, you're sure, yeah. I thought it was. Bad, no?
Because my next move is king f8. And
yeah, if you're in time, yeah. Looks like you might not, but probably you are, yeah. I mean, takes on c7, king f8, and yeah. Maybe, yeah, but unfortunately rook f8 also it was working, yeah. It's and okay, if my...
Yeah, but I was a bit worried of rook e2 here.
Yeah, but rookie two, I thought about it, but even just bishop goes, yeah, and I.
Yeah, the bishop has many moves, but.
I mean, like even just attacking.
Yeah, bishop d3 was best, but.
Yeah, because rookie eight, there is rook f7, yeah, I mean, I thought, no, I was actually trying to make some tricks here with some kind of strange line, making a move after rook f7. The trick was, okay, whatever move, for example, I mean, of course, it's not the right move. I mean, the trick was if bishop h7, then bishop f6 probably wins. But there is king g8, yeah, there is king g8 here always. I mean, no, I mean, not this, but rook takes c7, yeah, that was my idea, that maybe I can take on c7. And then, okay, takes probably, and this was a nice trick, because this seems to be all gone, but unfortunately, yeah, after king g8, I don't think I have anything here, so probably it's a logical draw that I just liquidated to the bishop to the endgame, yeah.
Sergey, somehow, I mean, it looked not that great, but on the other hand, did you have the feeling that you have enough resources to defend this position?
Yeah, actually it was more unpleasant when the position wasn't stabilized, and I felt like it's very tricky, but after we exchanged knights, I thought, okay, I'm slightly worse, but it should be holdable. But of course, it wasn't so easy at all, but okay.
One of your fans here in this event who came to watch you in your games, he said that probably you are putting yourself in purpose to the situations to defend such a difficult position, like you are challenging yourself every time. How can you comment on this?
Oh, but yesterday I just played very badly. I should have made a very simple draw and to go home. But I cannot explain some of my moves yesterday, and today it was just preparation of my opponent, and it just happened.
Do we have questions? Okay, Yulia, can you please help with microphone? There is a question.
Just one more question about this endgame. I think, if I'm not mistaken, there was a point when the black bishop was on c6 and white played bishop g5, and there would have been a possibility to play rook h1 to trade one pair of rooks. Was that something you considered, or why was it? Why would it have been a bad plan for black?
You mean for black?
Yes,
no,
to
that was. Yeah, no, that was, I think, very dangerous.
It was very dangerous, yeah. I didn't like it because.
Somewhere here, yeah.
Bishop
c6.
I was really hoping for it, yeah. I was,
the problem. The problem
I mean,
is
here, yeah. Yeah.
The problem that.
No, I guess I'm just mating, yeah. I mean,
king f4.
King f4 and then f6, the same plan. It might be just mate. Rook to h line and f6.
Rook h3, f6, yeah.
I mean, very, very dangerous. On the edge of losing, probably, yeah. So I thought, I was hoping, yeah, that, but
actually it's
work.
Tempting, yes, to change this rook, which actually on the edge.
Yeah, but in fact, this rook protects the king, and also it creates counterplay on h line. I mean, it's not a bad rook at all, in fact. I understood myself at some point that actually I would love to change this rook, but it's not so easy to manage it. I mean, I would probably do it myself if I could, just to change the rook, but I couldn't see how.
Okay, any other questions? Let's see. One more question, please.
Dylan Quersia, US Chess, and the 2018 documentary. How many moves deep were you in preparation? It's a question for both of you. It seems that there was a time difference between both of your clocks. So how far deep did you finish your preparation, and how hard was it if you finished early?
Okay, after rook f1, bishop b4, it's a very well known theory, but a3 is not the main move, and after takes, I just could not remember my notes. It's not that I didn't have any notes, but I just didn't remember, and I confused, and maybe I mixed up something, probably, but it's just hard to say. Maybe I can say it tomorrow.
As to me, I didn't confuse my notes because I checked them 1 hour before the game, this position. So I still can manage to remember if I checked it 1 hour before. And actually, yes, I mean, sometime, somewhere around knight bishop g5, c5, I mean knight d2, and somewhere here I just saw that white has a very nice position, and that was it, yeah. I mean, the rest I started to play on my own.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I think we checked everything about this game. Thank you so much for your comments. Thank you.